One time I drove to see a girl across the country. One night as I was driving through New Mexico, I had the windows wide open. It was cold and I was crying, and I laid her on the radio. Then I stopped outside of Tahoe's in this tiny mining town, had a diner to refill for the ride. And in the wind I heard this crying, like a heart broke right in two. I turned my collar up and went inside, where I saw this smiling waitress joshing friendly with these truckers. They'd give her a pat and she'd give them shoves. I said, "Miss, what's that awful crying?" Everybody laughed and said, "It's the tomb of the unknown love." And then they pointed out the window to a stone, all by itself beneath the tree beside a hill. And on that winter night I read these words alone, these words that are haunting me still. It said, "Here lies a young man struck down in his prime by the awesome burning power of love. He couldn't stand his true love cheating, so he shot that girl down. They hung him from that tree up above." I know that local folks say it's the wind, but I know it's crying from the tomb of the unknown love. So I drove on to my destination. I did the job my heart demanded of me. And when the sheriff's sirens came, I didn't even try to fight. They counted 10, I came out at 3. So now I guess tomorrow morning, warden reads some kind of paper, how I'm gonna pay the state for what I've done. Hey, then they'll put the shackles on me and we'll take a little walk. They won't have to drag me, cause it's said and done. And maybe someday they can put me up a stone, all by itself beneath the tree beside the hill. And lovers everywhere can come and read along these words that will give them a chill. And it'll say, "Here lies a young man struck down in his prime by the awesome burning power of love. He shot the girl down. They hung him from that tree right above." I know that local folks say it's the wind, but I know it's crying from the tomb of the unknown love.
Considered him the coward of the county. He'd never stood one single time to prove the county wrong. His mama named him Tommy, but folks just called him Yellow. Something always told me they were reading Tommy wrong. He was only 10 years old when his daddy died in prison. I looked after Tommy, cause he was my brother's son. I still recall the final words my brother said to Tommy. "Son, my life is over, but yours has just begun. Promise me, son, not to do the things I've done. Walk away from trouble. It won't mean you're weak if you turn the other way.
someone for everyone, and Tommy's love was Becky. In her arms he didn't have to prove he was a man. One day while he was working, the Gatlin boys came calling. They took turns at Becky, and there was three of them. Tommy opened up the door, saw his Becky crying. The torn dress, the shattered look, was more than he could stand. He reached above the fireplace and took down his daddy's picture. As his tears fell on his daddy's face, he heard these words again. Promise me, son, not to do the things I've done. Walk away from trouble if you can. Now it won't mean you're weak if you turn the other cheek. I hope you're old enough to understand. Son, you don't have to fight to be a man. The Gatlin boys just laughed at him when he walked into the bar room. One of them got up and met him halfway across the floor. When Tommy turned around, they said, hey, look, old Yellow's leaving. But you could have heard a pin drop when Tommy stopped and locked the door. 20 years of crawling was bottled up inside him. He wasn't holding nothing back. He let them have it all. When Tommy left the bar room, not a Gatlin boy was standing. He said, this one's for Becky, as he watched the last one fall. And I heard him say, I promised your dad not to do the things you've done. I'll walk away from trouble when I can. Now please don't think I'm weak, I didn't turn the other cheek. And Papa, I sure hope you understand. Sometimes you gotta fight when you're a man. Everyone considered him the coward of the county.
On a warm summer's evening, on a train bound for nowhere, I met up with a gambler. We were both too tired to sleep, so we took turns of staring out the window at the darkness till boredom overtook us. And he began to speak. He said, son, I've made a life out of reading people's faces and knowing what the cards were by the way they held their eyes. So if you don't mind my saying, I can see you're out of aces. For a taste of your whiskey, I'll give you some advice. So I handed him my bottle, and he drank down my last swallow. Then he bummed a cigarette and asked me for a light. And the night got deathly quiet, and his face lost all expression. Said, if you're gonna play the game, boy, you gotta learn to play it right. You got to know when to hold up, know when to fold up, know when to walk away, and know when to run. You never count your money when you're sitting at the table. There'll be time enough for counting when the dealing's done. Every gambler knows that the secret to surviving is knowing what to throw away, knowing what to keep. 'Cause every hand's a winner and every hand's a loser, and the best that you can hope for is to die in your sleep. And when he finished speaking, he turned back toward the window, crushed out a cigarette, faded off to sleep. And somewhere in the darkness, the gambler, he broke even.
But in his final words I found an ace that I could keep. You got to know when to hold up, know when to fold up, know when to walk away, and know when to run. You never count your money when you're sitting at the table. There'll be time enough for counting when the dealing's done. You got to know when to hold up,
when to hold up,
know when to fold up, know when to walk away, and know when to run. You never count your money when you're sitting at the table. There'll be time enough for counting when the dealing's done. You got to know when to hold up, know when to fold up, know when to walk away, and know when to run. You never count your money when you're sitting at the table. There'll be time enough for counting when the deal is done.
Belongs to everybody too. Daytime friends and nighttime lovers, hoping no one else discovers where they go, what they do in this secret hideaway. Daytime friends and nighttime lovers, they don't want to hurt the other, so they love in the nighttime and shake hands in the light of day.
And when it's over, there's no peace of mind, just a longing for the way things should have been. And she wonders why some men never find that a woman needs a lover and a friend.
Daytime friends and nighttime lovers, hoping no one else discovers where they go, what they do in their secret hideaway. Daytime friends and nighttime lovers, they don't want to hurt the other, so they love in the nighttime and shake hands. Secret hideaway. Daytime friends and nighttime lovers, they don't want to hurt the other, so they love in the nighttime and shake hands.